A bit closer. We're just going to work around this one area all together. Come in. Right, pad. Tackler on his knees. Ball carrier with the ball there. Two support players, please. So it's a grid of six as such. And the rest of you just come round. Now this drill, you can use this for anything. Now a big improvement in our game over the last couple of months is the work of the ball carrier. Rooking becomes a lot easier if the action of the ball carrier is instant. Too much in rugby, the tackler, the carrier, does nothing on the floor. So it's about groundwork. It's about rolling again. So Kareem, tackled. Yeah, compromise either. It's the action of this guy like that. That is not good enough. Right? We will tell our guys off and indeed mark them down if they don't make an action now. What can they do here? What can they do now as a carrier? Hold on to him.
Yeah.
No, just stay there, man. What can you do now?
Wriggle around.
It's
football placement.
Yeah. Minimum is lift the ball back. Actually move his torso back to me. Demo cream, that's... Right, if you can't do that, what else can you do? We mentioned it earlier. 360, we call it, roll again. Quick action. Look at the Welsh team, very good at this. Go back to the start. So, a drill now. We'll start compromise, so a tackle on his knees. On the go, take the tackle. As soon as that happens, the pads come in. You're the support players. So you're the defenders and support players, you've got to race them in. You've got to clear them pads beyond. Right? Simple as that. An attacking breakdown drill, which will turn into a defensive counter-hooking drill in a moment. Okay, so we're going to do that. Keep rotating in. This bit is full on. Make it as hard as possible for him.
Yep.
Right? So try and pull him back. Try and hold him down.
Oh,
I'm not going to penalise you for not rolling away. For the purpose of this drill.
Well, I've got stem legs, yeah?
Yeah, at the start. Otherwise, you're going to put him over there, aren't you?
Naturally.
In your dreams, mate. Right, as soon as that happens, you guys race in. You guys start on your front. So I'm compromising you. Start on your front. Yeah? So as soon as that starts, you've got to get in there, support players. And all you've got to do is just clear the area completely. Go! Clear. Guys. Hold it there. What can they do best? Arriving. What can they do better? Lower. Yeah, lower. So from a meter out, I want you horizontal. Do the same thing again. A meter out horizontal. Take them away. Go! Clear. Kareem, okay, good action. Always two hands on the ball. Swap over. Same drill, keep swapping around. We do this every day. Do a bit of contact every day. Not always full on. But a bit of contact every day in terms of our groundwork. Let's go again. Go! Pads in. Clear. Lower. Bit lower in terms of a clear out. Get lower. Next, in. Now what you can do, I'm not going to do it now, but you can have two drills going side by side. Start one, then the other. Keep alternating. Start. Go! Go on, get hold of him. Lift the ball back, lift. Brilliant. Go. Clear beyond. Okay, you get a picture, right? You can develop that as much as you want. Right, next group in, please. Now we've been caught in the tackle. So you've been tackled, right? And you're on your back. You hold him on his back. So you've caught him in a compromised tackle. We get this a lot in rugby. James Haskell, good at this. A lot of the Irish back row, good at this. On the go, I want you to roll. Or lift your body back and you do the same thing. You just do the same drill as before. Just clear out. Yeah? Right, go! Tackers, okay, swap over, good. Go! Come on, get behind, clear behind! Brilliant, well done, lads. Good, let's have another group quickly. Go! Come on, get there, urgency, get there, clear behind! Boom! Right, get a picture. Right, that's how I develop that, so you're developing a bit of rook. Rook touch, I call it, that game we're playing earlier, into a bit of full on. Now the pads come back, these can be full on players. You've got those body suits to practice in? Wear them, you can make this as tasty as you want. Okay, just developing it now. Now it becomes a counter-hook drill. So you're now the carrier.
Yep.
Right, you're a tackler. on his knees. All I want from you is to take the tackle. So it's always a dominant tackle. For counter-rooking, the decision is if it's a kick, if you're kicking, you're exiting from your own half, or if you've got a dominant tackle, get up, counter-rook. What do you call counter-rooking? Do you have a call for it?
No, just fire.
Fire?
Fire, yeah.
Everyone uses fire. Why is that? Fire. Fire, fire. Fire. Okay, so get up, fire, fire, will you join in? I want you all calling fire. Right, you've got to counter-rook those pads.
Yeah.
What are you laughing at? Fire's a good word. Now, with counter-rooking, don't nose-dive. This is the same as a normal clear-out. You see a lot of counter-rooking, people just nose-dive, get penalised for going off the feet. So it's the same thing for you. Right, so take the tackle, dominant tackle, go! Onto your feet, go! Fire, 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 fire! Right, nice, checkers! Double tackle, get to your feet. Fire, 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 get behind, no nose dive. Well done, mate, well done. Never look down, clear out, never look down. If you look down, you're going to go down. Get through. Quick swap again. Go. Put it back, up to your feet, Kareem. Good lad, good lad. Next, if you can't get up in that situation, get up, get out of the way.
All right.
Right, otherwise you get pinged. Go! Dominant tackle! Boom! Back to your feet! Fire, fire, fire! Break, get beyond, get beyond! Break. Okay, so that's what I'll do. That's what I'll do, right? Just chuck all the kit off. So develop, warm up, touch. Touch game, you can make what you want. Break down both sides of the ball, then into scrummaging. Any questions so far? Yes, sir.
When Kareem got stuck in that point, you said get out.
Yeah.
Best way to get out, that way or that
side?
Way,
just get out the side.
Get out anyway.
Yeah. Get outside, because what he was, it wasn't that much of a dominant tackle, was it? But his mates had made the decision for him.
Because he'd still finished in, he compromised the tackle, he still finished on top.
He did.
But his head was going that way.
He looked wrong, didn't he? To just get out. Right. If he can't get out and instantly go forward, as he gets up from the tackle, if he's not getting up and squaring or going forward, I'd encourage him to get out. Right. Especially when the ruck's formed. If there's not a ruck formed, he's the tackler, he's got all the rights, isn't he? Yeah. He can get up, hover over the ball. Arse facing the opposition, can't he? Like Richard McCoy did for years. But as soon as that looks for him, get out.
But which way? That's my question, was which way? Because anyway.
The quickest way for him, it was out sideways, wasn't it? He can't exit through the back, his mates are coming through. He can't go through there, because you're going back into the ruck he shouldn't be in.
Yep.
Any more questions? Okay, come in now, lads, let's scrum. Getting warm for scrummaging. What do we need to get warmed up now? We've got shoulders going a bit in that, haven't we? Especially if you've done live clear out there. Shoulders are warm. Ears hanging off, or is that just me when I play? Now we're going to need to get our core warmed up. I'll talk about a core and a body position a lot. You've heard of the tower of power. But basically, we all need to be practicing getting in a flex position like that with a core switched on. That's scrummaging. Yeah, we get everyone in that core position like that, we're in business. That's all scrummaging is, as I said in there. So to get our core warmed up, you love this, don't you? Come on, show us.
Wrestling.
The wrestling drill. Who's going to go with Kareem? Good volunteer.
Go on, more Kareem.
Right. It was a good idea at the time, wasn't it? Let's go and train. Right, line top. Right, you're going to do this. Your moment. Right, on the go. Kareem's going to go.
Don't let him up, more Kareem.
Yeah, don't let him up. Don't let him up. Don't let him up. Don't let him up. Boom. Break. Okay. And he didn't get up as well. Come on, Kareem. Right, in pairs around here doing that. Go on, get up! No one's going to break while we're going to the far side. Stop! Swap over! Well, hey, no hands in fake. Hey, calm down. Okay, already, how are you stopping him getting up? You can't say gouging.
Just depending on which way he's going, I'm trying to counteract that.
You're getting your weight on him, aren't you? You're using core already, right? So we're using our core already. Okay, next drill. Kareem, on all fours. You love this one. Right, down. We're going to scrimmage against him. Right, going to put your head under there. Look forward. You've got to move him. How's Kareem going to defend that? How's this player going to stop being pushed? Come in, lads. How's he going to stop? He's already doing it.
Does he have to keep his knees?
Sorry?
Yes, keep his knees up. That's the rule.
Yeah, keep his knees on the floor. Yeah. This guy's just kind of scrimmage. All you've got to do is try and push him that way. Like this, Kareem's going to stop him by getting in that already. He's got into that scrum shape. In this drill now, the more you drop your core, flex like that, the more you won't be moved. Go!
Ball, Kareem.
break, see the shape of cream there? Okay, we'll do that, I'll start you off. So take the strain. 2, 1, go! Go on, drop your core, drop the core. Break! How does that feel?
There you go,
that's good.
What makes it easier?
Maintaining your shape.
Neutral head.
Excellent. Okay, so we've got our core.
Yeah.
What you're going to hear me talk about a lot in a moment is studs in the deck. Is having your studs in the deck, right? Curling your toes. Right, so let's have me and Kareem in the middle. Now sub that. Here, you go in the middle. Right, soon we're pushing. Right. There's a circle now. We're going to form a circle, but you've got to push them out of the circle. Go on. 3, 2, 1. Oh, whoa, hold it. Well, break. Already. You see, do it again. Just take the strain of a single push. There, now, hold it round. Hold that shape now. Look up. Look up over your eyes. Switch that a bit more. Curl your toes. Think about putting everything through the deck. Move out the way. Move out the way. See already what we've turned them into? A scrummaging animal. Already. Now, this is everything we're going to do. At the start, jump out. When I said just push cream out, he went in like that, didn't he? Come here. He went in double part like that. But as soon as I adjusted him there, studs in the deck, core switched on, positive hips, that's how we scrum. Right, so we'll get in the pairs, I'll start you. Hold him. I'm going to ask you to push or pull. Pull, you've got to drop your core as well. Push studs in the deck, pull, you've got to drop your core. All very pertinent to scrummaging.
One of us working and we talk around and we're both trying to do the same thing.
You're both trying to do the same thing. So you're trying to pull each other out of the circle or push each other out of the circle. Pull! Break! Break! Swap partners! Swap partners, take the strain! Push! Swap partners, break! Take the strain, sweat partners. When you're doing this a few times, or for a few weeks, as a warm-up drill, please, when you're doing it a few times, perfection is either push or pull. There's no movement. There's no jerking. When you're doing it a few weeks, everything's switched on in terms of your core. When that happens, you've got somewhere. Right, in terms of your warm-up, you've got somewhere in terms of your posture. We've got that, so that's how we warm up into our scrummaging. Now we need to build a scrum. So let's have a tight head, hooker, lock. Loose head, hooker, lock. Now for this, one of you is going to be, come the other way. Lads, come the other way so you can see. So I can see the audience. Come on. One of this. Let's add a flanker on. Flanker. And a flanker here. So it's 4-on-4.
Roughly.
Now, if back at your clubs, you've not got enough. You can all see, just come round here. If you've not got enough for live scrummaging, pack on pack, do this. If you've only got one pack at training, just do 4-on-4. I do loads of this, because you find a lot out about players and about body shape. You're the scrum machine, right? So you're just going to push. For this first bit, you're going to start connected. When I say go, just want you to go. All say the same thing at the same time. Go squeeze 2, 3, 4, squeeze 2, 3, 4, squeeze 2, 3, 4, right? Can you all manage that? What am I looking for?
Body shape.
Body shape, right? When I say squeeze 2, 3, 4, I don't want hips coming up. Everything through the deck. Through our toes in the deck. Squeeze 2, 3, 4, squeeze just a couple of inches at a time. You're going to march them forward. You're going to take it.
Okay.
Right? Yep. It's not an ego trip. Take it. You'll get your go in a minute. You don't want to take it, do you?
I'll take it.
I heard. Right, come in. Right, tight connection. We'll come to that in a moment. All I'm after is a good body shape. Right, fall in. Just fold in. I'm not after an engagement. Okay, take the strain, Kareem's team. Ready? Go.
Squeeze.
2, 3, but hold. Go.
Squeeze.
Going quietly. Now you take it. You're a scrum machine. Take it. Go.
Squeeze.
Hold. I'll keep our shape. Again, one more time.
Squeeze. 2, 3, 4.
Break. Okay, what do you think? What do you think? Are they all together?
No.
You're not together. You're not together talking wise.
No, we're just letting
and we're just moving around.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll have another go in a moment. It's all right.
Job and all.
You'll go. Right. Yep. Fold him. Perfection. Perfection. Listen. Perfection is everyone doing the same thing at the same time, right? Not coming off. Squeeze, two, three, four. Let's hear you call it. And the go. Ready? Go.
Squeeze.
Hold.
And squeeze.
Hold.
And squeeze.
Break. Brilliant. Okay, so you're gonna start. Okay, everything together, nice and tight. Squeeze two, nice and quiet. Squeeze two, three, four. Squeeze two. Okay.
Yeah.
Go on, fold him, just fold him. Go on, tighten the arms. Go!
And squeeze!
Hold!
And squeeze!
Hold!
Yep.
And squeeze!
Brilliant, well done, really good. Fold in. Go!
And squeeze!
Hold!
And squeeze!
Hold, feet under you!
And squeeze!
Hold, one more!
Brilliant!
Hey, we've come a long way there, from the start. What do you think of that? Yeah? Together, aren't we? Right, since the start we got a lot tighter, got together. Still, lads, come in. As we go, squeeze, two, three, four, we come up. Stay down. Keep that lid closed. Squeeze, two, three, four. So you can build that up as much as you want. Same drill, back to the start. Start now with a hit. So four and four again. I'll call it crouch, bind, set, hit. This time, I'm looking for the first actions in the engagement. Crouch, bind, set. Holding shape. Right, holding our feet. Nice and quiet, studs in the deck. Yeah? The battle these days in the scrum is about who doesn't move the feet in the set. You've got to wait for them to move their feet. I'll come to that more in a moment. Does that make sense? So it's the first actions of the engagement I'm after now. Crouch, bind, set, drop, core on, positive hips. We've got that. Back to the starting group. Crouch, bind, set. Hold. Squeeze. Stay there. Don't lose shape. Look at the shape of this fella. Don't lose shape. And this dude, good. Don't lose shape. Break. What do you think? Pretty good, eh? Pretty good. Really. Now, a little tip. If you're doing a bit of fitness, or you want to test them out of the scrimmage and do a bit of fitness before this, and the guy who loses shape first, you can see very clearly from this type of drill, that's your poor scrimmager. And if you're filming it, you can tell them afterwards, well, you lost your shape first. It's great for picking out those second rows who give up after a while, or hookers who give up after a while. This is a great way of doing it. Even better if you pre-fatigue them. Okay, swap in. Crouch. Bind. Sit! Hold there, keep your elbow up. Head in there, hold your head there. Hold, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, break. Excellent. Well done, don't do that. Don't put your head out, why?
I'm getting
things. Why are you doing it there? You've got to stay tight to your hooker. Never lose your head on the outside, always keep it tight. If you've got, imagine you've got glasses on, we'll come to that in a moment. Imagine you've got glasses on, looking over your glasses, stay tight. If you lose your head out, you're going to get hurt. And your tire is going to come right through, we'll come to that in a moment. In fact, we'll go front five on front five, same thing, right? Hey, look at me. No ego trips, nothing goes down, yeah? Hit and hold, stop looking at me, look at him. Crouch, bind. Sit! Hold shape. Tighten arms! Right, tighten arms! Put your head in there. Elbow up, that's it. Now pinch my fingers together. Hold! Come on, hold it! Four! Keep your head down. 3, 2, 1, break! Well done. Same with you. Just keep your head calm. Yeah. Right. You've got a line here down the middle of your body. Keep your head in that line. If you move your head out of line, you're going to lose power. You're going to come through. Right, you went from there to there with me just moving you. You put your head under here. Lift your elbow. Happy? Happy? What do you think of the shape?
Touch high.
Touch high?
Yeah.
Yeah, a bit high. Particularly as we're getting more fatigued, the more I'm counting, we're going, aren't we? It happens in the game. Do it again. Right, if you look at me now, if you look at me, if your head goes on the outside, you're going home.
That's okay.
Look straight. Lift your elbow. Look straight. In line. Elbow. Crouch. Bind. Sit. Hold shape. Don't look at me. Look forward. Hold. 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 Now let's tighten our arms. Tighten our arms, everyone. Let's drop it half an inch. Lower. Hold. Look forward. Look forward. Look forward. Break. Well done. Really good. Last bit before we move on. 8 and 8. Same drill. Hit and hold in shape. Crouch. Bind. Sit. Hold, 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 hold. All right, everyone tighten their arms. Everyone, imagine there's a 50p between your blades. Try and tighten your shoulder blades. Try and look forward. Studs in the deck. Core on. Come on, keep your core on. Hold, hold, hold. Break. Well done. Well done. Now, you can be as pedantic as you want to be in terms of building this up. It depends ultimately how much time you've got in your session. But if you get everyone the same posture, the same timing, the same willingness to hold that position, the same willingness not to move their feet, you're in business. You're in business. The proximity of the scrum now, we're pre-engaged. Test rugby is all pre-engaged. Premiership rugby, still some teams give you a little gap, but the game will go to pre-engage before long, which is good in my opinion, because it's about those teams who can maintain their shape in that pre-engagement. And as I keep saying, if you all get your posture right, you get your feet right, we'll move now into our body shapes in terms of hooking the ball. Sometimes you can't hook the ball, so what do you do then? Walk over it. You can only walk over it if everyone's feet are in the deck. You can only walk over, you have a timed, and now, if you watch Saracens play, we're playing Saracens at Wembley at the weekend. Saracens actively will not hook the ball. The nine will put it in the middle of the scrum, and they will leave it there. They will leave it there. And all they're waiting to do, all they're waiting to do, we have the same tactic, all you're waiting to do is for somebody to give up in the opposition, for some second row to lose shape, for someone to get bored. The minute one of the rivets go in their seams, in their scrum, you've got them. So that's why I say the scrum now is a battle of not moving your feet. So that ball there, we endeavour to hook the ball, because I want the option to play away from the base. If we can't hook the ball, we have a call saying, brace, brace, which I'll move on to in a moment. Brace, 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 which means I'm not going to hook the ball, we're going to walk over it. Then it's a, and now! And all you've got to do on that and now, as long as your hips are on, your toes are in the deck, they'll give up first. That's why scrimmaging is about your feet. That's why I urge you to take your time in building up individual posture and shape. 1-on-1, 2-on-2, 4v4, 5v5, 8v8, to practice hit and holding shape. That's what I'm here for, mate.
Right, so when you're saying like you're waiting for someone like a rivet to go or a part to go, are you relying on one person to make a call when that's happened? Or
no, you'll feel it. You'll feel it. Inevitably, yeah. The hooker, yeah. That's why he's your scrum leader. He's the one moron with his hands tied behind his back in the middle of the scrum. Right. Right, so make him the boss for that.
Right.
But he can feel that.
So he would normally be the one that says, like,
yes.
Yeah.
He can feel. The biggest seam in a scrum to go is between the hooker and tied. He can feel an opposition ball when he's going through that.
Right.
He goes, ah, no, we got him, we got him, we got him. Or he's the one in your own ball that's going, hey, please, I'm looking at the ball, no one move, help me, and go again.
Right.
Yeah, I repeat, you've got to endeavour to hook the ball. I'll come on to that in a moment. Someone remembered to ask me about hooking drills you can do all year round in the when we get the questions after, remind me about that. Some great drills you can do in the gym with a Swiss ball, because we have a generation of hookers who have never hooked. Where was I? Scrums! Right, let's set it up. Now we'll build it down. Technically, what's going to put us in the best position to hook the ball? Hooker. Hooker?
Yep.
I thought you were a prop.
No.
Hooker.
Yep.
In charge of the scrum. Get there first. Right, what's his position like? What's your body shape like? What do you need to do as a hooker?
Possibly.
What do you need? You need to hook the ball, right? Yep. So you get to the scrum with your right leg forward, right? Flex like that, knee over your toe. Never have it too far out. Why not? Oh, come on, you're doing my head in here. You dropped already. Now, see, I'll demonstrate. So hooker's in charge, right? Get there. Hooker's got to have his right leg forward at the start because he's going to hook the ball with it. You see, a lot of hookers who get to the scrum like this with the handbrake on. Crouch, bind, so, not going anywhere, right? You get beaten in the engagement, I'm not going to be able to move my foot anywhere, so how am I going to hook the ball? So hooker there, get there, knee over his toe, crouch, bind, set, so he goes over that and he can hook the ball. That makes sense? Do that. Brilliant. Okay, get there, hold good shape. Imagine that 50p. Right, get there now. Now it's up to the rest of the team to get under there. So front rowers, tight head. Thank you, Carl Heyman. not too much. Go, no. Make him come down to you. Go an inch. That's better. Right, Carl Heyman bolts on there. Most important player in the scrum. Highest paid player in the scrum. Mostly. Why? Why?
Because the
key goes,
the whole thing goes.
Yeah, he's the cornerstone. Everything's through him. Breakout. Stay there, Carl Heyman. Nice shape. You go out, mate. You jump out. Dropped. Everything comes through him. So he's going to have this great shape here. Come back in again. He's got to be in front. Why is the tight end got to be in front of a hooker? He's the first guy you want to bind up with. The rest of them, unimportant. Who says cheap? 10 a penny. That's where I played. Tight head, just in front. Why is he just in front?
He goes in first.
Who said that? Excellent. Why does he go in first?
Depends if it's our ball, the hooker's going to be looking slack to the left and he goes in front.
Exactly, because the hooker's right side of his body has to go forward, because he's got to hook the ball. If the tight head doesn't get hit first, look already what's happened to the hooker. He's now got to go, hey, try and hook the ball. So tight has got to be in front. Just a bit in front. You said you're the add-on. Cheap. I was right, wasn't I? I was right. How about that? Right, go on, Grim. Now, Feel your way around him. Whatever
he wants,
he has. With a small tight head prop, some of them have shorter binds across the back. To bind again. I like this because you bind on the shorts. Too many props these days you see on the shirt like that. That's rubbish. Right, you're just going to get split. Those rivets and those seams, you're going to get popped. So get hold of him around his shorts, right? You find your way in. Okay, Lou said, put that foot back. Lou said you're a sprinter. Yeah, look at me. Lou said you're in a sprint position because you're attacking the target. Yep. Put your inside foot back.
Sure.
That's it, back a bit more. Right, whatever it takes, bring that shoulder through. I want your shoulder in line with the hooker. In line with the hooker. In line there. I want your hips in line there. Yours just in front. You'll see that picture. Bit of dignity there. You'll see that picture there. Like a table football game that you're playing in the arcade. It's going to look like that. So bring that bit more forward. Bring your hips through. Shoulder just through there. That's what we're going to be. Lads, are you tired?
Yeah.
You all right? Break! Just have a little front row. Excellent. Form up. This, be really pedantic about this, because there's a massive difference to how you hook the ball. Let's have a little front row in. Now, if the tight head prop is 100 yards away at the bottom of the hook, you wait for him, right?
Yeah.
Then he comes to you first. Go. Under him, Green. Nice. Just in front. Come through a bit more, dude. Hips there, like you bolt on. Nice, that's nice. All right, can you come through a bit more? Right, we're leading set up still a bit. Clean a bit more. That's it. Nice. What do you think? Right? Be dead pedantic about this. I still think you can get through a bit more clean. Getting through a bit more. Get through.
Yeah, buddy.
Now break there.
Go.
I'm gonna stay there. Now just hold it there. Come through a bit more. Right, hold it there. Now, as an opposition, your loose head has got to have his shoulder through there. If your loose head has his shoulder too far behind, I'm going to attack that as a tight head. Right, you're opening me up straight to go under your hooker's right shoulder there. So loose head, bring your shoulder through, and that keeps the tight head, see already, that contains the tight head on the loose head. Big, that's a massive big deal that is, yeah? Opposition tight head is going to be contained by the loose head. Conversely here, tight head, have your inside shoulder through. Right, just put it away behind. Now if he's like that, put your arm up. Are you getting tired, mate?
No.
If your tight head is too far behind there, the opposition hooker can get right under this shoulder. Tight, bring your shoulder through now. Now that now is on top of the opposition hooker's head. So the tight head is protecting the, this guy's shoulder because the tight is going to take him on with that shoulder. So opposition hooker now is caught here. Now go back to him. If he's there, I can get to here. But bring it forward. Now drop it, drop your shoulder on my head. Right there. Does that make sense? Those little micro details with the new scrum now, your back row is still listening. You are, aren't you? You love this, don't you? Those micro details now, particularly around where the shoulders are, that's the scrum. As I said to you, the scrum now is mostly pre-engaged. So the more you can keep that shoulder occupying me as a tired, Kareem, that shoulder's through there, keeping me as a hooker out, because if you give me too much there, I'll attack and come across. Feel the difference there?
Yep.
They're the micro details, right? Those things you can do every day as a front row in training, 3-on-3, every session. Yes, sir.
So now the fashion as well is to kind of get in that shape before you bind up.
Yes.
Traditional.
Yes.
Get into it.
Yes.
As a front row.
Yeah.
Why is it? What does that do?
The less moving parts, the better.
Right.
The less change. Imagine you're knackered. 40-minute balling play time. You're knackered. The less moving parts. At the scrum in the 79th minute, you just get to your scrum shape. Ireland do it better than anyone. They get to the scrum, they bend over like that. They're in a pushing position. The less you have going on in the scrum, the better. That makes sense.
Yeah.
I'm not convinced, have I? It's all right, we'll build on it.
Sure.
Form up again. So, show me that detail. Boom. Boom. There, nice shape. So we're semi-crouched already. How's that bind feel, Lou said? Just clean, let him under a bit. There we go. Yeah. No. You still have that bind. Just let accommodate him the last minute. Second row's coming. You thought I forgot you, didn't I?
No, never.
Hey. Find your way in. On one knee, please, just on one. Now, second rows, try and kiss your elbow. Now, already, all that does, that drops everything down. Now, try and kiss the elbow, it brings the head into that tight position, because you don't want the second rows pushing on the biceps. It already swallows up the shoulder by trying to kiss the elbow. On one knee, flankers join in, please. Today, you're four bones, you aren't you? Right, nice and tight. This is a row of four here. Number eight, come in, please. We'll come to your row in a minute. Crouch, come off your knees, crouch. Bind, feet back. Set. Wait, hold it there. You see a lot of teams, in answer to your question, you see a lot of teams in the Premiership or around the world who will go on to double knee in the back five. So you're like, they're all sat down, you've got the front row up, back five joining, double knee, going to one knees, and they go crouch, bind, and they all come up at the last moment. Right, that completely unbalances your front row. So you want your back five coming up on the crouch. So you join on one knee, crouch, bind, just put your feet back, set. That's my point. The less moving parts just before the scrum, the better. That's why your front row, when you arrive, you're in all three quarter crouch. Second row, arrive on one knee, crouch, off one knee, bind, everyone's feet back, set. You're limiting the moving parts just before the engagement. Does that make sense?
Surely if both your feet, your knees on the ground, you're only going up once and that's just one movement.
It's unbalanced. It's too much movement.
Okay. Fair enough.
Try it. You obviously go like double knee, don't you?
Sorry?
You obviously like going down onto double knee.
That's how I've been doing it the whole season.
Yeah. As you get fatigued, if you come up late, you'll come up into that position to nose diving.
Okay.
Then you just give them the front row nothing. If you go onto one knee, you just come up nice horizontal, early, set. If you go double knee, you'll come up like that. I promise you.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
On that one, when you just start again, tight head started to roll in just before engage, just literally once the twos came in. Is it just the way the arms are binding, or have you played loose head?
No.
No, it just natural body shape seems to be doing that, and you see that a lot in games.
Yeah.
Whether it's this scrum factory stuff that's been...
No, we don't want that at all. We'll have a look at that. No, we want everyone square, everyone in their own lane, everyone nice and square. Right, let's do two packs, right, but build it as we just built that one there. So two hookers. Right, tight heads. Seconds. Hang on, are we in? Find your way in there. Shoulders through. Remember, shoulders through. Seconds, flankers. Flankers. Well volunteered. Flankers. Onto one knee, remember, you're going to come up on the crouch, everyone. Crouch. Bind. Set. Hold. Break. Good. Let's do it again.
On you, you set.
Yeah. Give me a ball. Crouch. Bind. Set. Hold. Break. How's that feel, lads?
Yeah.
Right? There's still a lot of little micro detail we're going to get better, but in the second rows, philosophy-wise, how's it feel? Different.
Yeah. It feels way more stable. I don't know if that's
because
of that.
Whoa. It feels what?
Way more stable.
It feels way more stable.
As in,
you'll take that, won't you?
Absolutely.
Oh, it feels way more stable.
I'd say that's the word from these three, though.
No, I promise you, it is. If you all come up on the crouch, right? Now, the next bit, we'll come back to front row. We'll look at number eight. So just give me a pack here on the row. You're watching. We're going to drop it right down now. We've done the hard work. Who's at number eight here? You. And your sister's trainers. Right, let's set it up then. Set up the scrum into the pre-crouch position. Okay, so front row is now, we're three-quarter crouched, aren't we, from the start. Shoulder through. Come in, square up, mate, square up. Hey, look at me, square up. Get your shoulder through. That's it. Second row is in. Now, number eight, you really want to be really clever about it. Get your head in there. Now you start pulling back. Start pulling the shorts back. Crouch. Get up on the crouch. Crouch. Bind. Break. Hold it there. Break there. So number eight now is almost the anchor of the scrum. Now the more number eight gets, number eight binds from the start. So he puts his head in before they even get off the floor. So number eight arrives, head in, crouch, he's pulling them back, which allows him to do what?
Push-ups.
crouching.
Which allows everyone to lean, doesn't it? Which allows, remember, crouch, leaning, bind, front, number eight stops, pulling, puts his feet back and he's starting to push. Which means on the bind segment, you're already putting weight through them. Not early, but you're already putting weight through them. Which means on the set, you just drop into it. So look at that then, two packs. No, number eight, man.
Oh, right.
Kieran Reid.
Put
your head on the crouch, be pulled back on the bind, start pushing. Not too much. Get your head in, Carl Heyman. Crouch. Bind. Set. Hold it there. Break. Break. Brilliant. Yeah, you got that. You'll see what happened there. Yeah, number eight started the scrum, didn't he? So number eight provides the anchor so everyone can lean. Crouch, bind, number eight starting to push. You watch Billy Vulnerable play for Saracens. On the bind segment, he drops his hands and binds through the legs of the second row to get maximum push through. So that means you're starting the scrum from the back already. You're not engaged, pre-engaged completely, but on the bind you can put a lot of weight through. Does that all sense? Big deal that. If you can get up on the crouch, with your number eight pushing already, bind, sorry, not with your number eight pushing on the bind, set, do you feel that weight from behind then? It's a big deal, isn't it? Then you just drop into the scrum. Gentlemen, you had some questions.
It's actually about the second row bind.
Yeah, certainly.
So binding on the shorts, on the waistband.
Yeah.
Fist in or fist out.
Fist in.
But more about binding across.
Yeah.
Onto the pocket.
Yeah. Kiss your elbow, that kind of shape.
But to get actually right across onto the pocket, to get the chest onto the buttock?
That's up to prop preference. I hated it when second row's bound through onto the pocket.
Right.
I don't like it, right in the middle like that.
No. I found it constricted me.
Right.
I might be different to you.
You're saying always arm like that though?
No.
I'll
come to that in a moment, yeah, right? Yeah. Whatever works for you. But I always found just onto my waist, not across my short, because it used to nip my leg. I've tried that bind through on you, that wrist bind before, but it promotes that. Promotes bicep pushing.
I suppose more with kids, but sometimes it pulls the hips forward because the second row's weight's pulling them forward.
I've never considered that. I just found it would. Your second row's end up like that. So through there, waistband kissing elbows. And another thing as well, let them worry about putting the heads in. Don't let them go, oh, let me get my head in. That's second rows. Let them find their own way in, because it's tight.
Just on that point, Graham, I don't know, you can see it when Kareem's scrummaging down there, his hips are quite a way away from his hookers when he's going in. So almost there's almost like a turn in already to go in there.
You're getting some shit here, mate.
Shots fired, mate.
I don't know, is that something?
No, you're right. You're right. Right. Let's build it up again. Right, are we happy? Are we happy from behind?
Yeah.
No, it's a good point. It's all right, he's going to come and knock you out in a minute. Right, big deal. Second rows arrive on one knee, up on the crouch. Number eight arrive, head in. Binding, pulling back on the, up on the crouch, pulling back on the bind. Number eight is in a pushing position. Yeah, put it through from the start. That'll make a massive difference to your scrum. I promise you, try it. You'll have less going on. If you're all coming up off double knee on the bind segment, the front row are getting that late. Penalty time. Right, he's going to square you up. Let's go again. Square up. Now, all I need now is just front fives, please. Front fives. Kareem, what you want to do? In terms of tight head squaring up, sir. In terms of tight head squaring up, The terminology, what I would use to use, think 1 o'clock.
Okay.
Think 1 o'clock on the loose head. Take them on at 1 o'clock, right? As in a clock.
Yeah.
That's midday.
Yeah.
That's 1 o'clock.
Yeah.
So you're going to be square now. 1 o'clock is hitting out on him there.
Yeah.
Crouch!
Hang on.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Crouch! Bind! 1 o'clock, Kareem. 1 o'clock. Set! Already. Break! Excellent, Kareem. Already, you're squarer. Yeah.
So don't set directly straight, sir.
No.
Okay.
No.
All right.
No. It's not a good sign, this. It's not a good sign. I didn't want to get this far. Let me just come in it tight. So all you have to do, and on another match, another point as well, you don't have to be super tight early on. It's not the 70s, right?
Like edge line.
Yeah, you don't have to be with the bloody tight edge under your armpits. You don't have to be super tight till the last minute. Right, I'm more concerned about everyone being in lane, everyone with shoulders out, everyone with good posture. So let's arrive again. Hooker. Now, you've done enough. Hooker. Right, tired. All you got to do is quietly come in here. Quietly. I'm ready. See where my head is now? See where I'm looking? 1 o'clock. Crouch. We're there. If you watch, the best loose head in the Six Nations is who?
Jamal.
Best tight head?
Dan Cook.
He's all right.
Who would you say? Furlong?
Todd Furlong, right? Yeah. Arrives there. He's in this position already. 1 o'clock. Square. Everything's square. Crouch. Bind. Right, on the bind segment, you go tight.
Tight.
That's when you tighten up. Set. Let's do it again. Right, show me.
Tight.
My point is... I didn't say that high pitched. My point is this, you have to be tight at the last second. The rest of the time you just get nice and comfy and in your own lane. Let's go again. 1 o'clock, Kareem.
We're going as well, yeah?
No. Just these, sorry. Drop it dead technical now, you've done your bit. Crouch. Bind.
Tight.
Excellent. Right, go five and five again. Break up. Do it again. This time, get square up more. Square up even more.
Is his left foot being back, causing the inside shoulder to roll?
Let's have a look this time. Let's have a look.
I'm rolling now.
Have you propped before?
And what? Obviously, he's done off that road
players.
Crouch. Bind.
Tight.
That's all right. Set!
Hit.
1 o'clock, Kareem, 1 o'clock! It's fine.
See what I mean? He's starting going in.
That's fine there. He's square there.
He is now, but yeah. What I'm saying at the start,
yeah.
It's just bringing his shoulder back.
Yeah. Fine. Break! Sorry. Get up! Sorry. Okay. Sorry.
Because, I mean...
Make your point. Tell everyone.
If you were going to scrummage against him, would you go long and drag his shorts because his body's already going?
What are you suggesting? I cheat?
Not at all.
No,
not
I wouldn't.
But for me, when he's setting up, because he's setting up with that left foot slightly back, his shoulder's actually coming back.
You've got to have your left foot back.
But if I was going to bind on you...
You can't have it up. You can't have it up at all. No, you can't. You could have it just slightly back as well, because you're more controlled like that. If my foot's up like that, I'm off balance. You look, all tighter props are all like that, some more than others. Okay. The taller tighter props will start like that. Look at Dan Cole starts like that.
Okay.
But you've got to have that left foot back.
But then your shoulders come through more and allowed me to throw in on my ball or attack him on their ball.
I'd always coach my tight head just to have his left foot a bit back. Okay. Always a bit back. Loose head, conversely, the opposite. Not too much. Tight head, probably. You're a squatter in the gym, but ever so slightly staggered like that. Loose head, probably you're a sprint star.
Yeah.
Let's have a look at the loose head. Then we'll go inside. It's a good job it's not raining. Now, as a loose head, now you've got to contain the tight head. The last thing you can do is try and go on the outside. You're just going to let him straight through you. You've got to take him on there. You've got to get your head there.
Yeah.
As a few real said earlier on, come closer, boys. Earlier on, a lot of the loosers were arriving here. You've got to attack quickly. Attack on the crouch bind set. Attack his heart with your head. Right? With your shoulder through, not too far behind. Shoulder through. Crouch, bind. Arm not too wide. Arm through. Crouch, bind, set, attack him and square him up. You've got to engage him quick, as Alou said. If you're passive and behind, the tight can get across you and onto your hooker. You're protecting your hooker. Come on then, kid. Come on! Come on, set up. Tight heads. Come on here. Right, Luke said, no, watch. No, go easy. Right? Remember, I coach at your club. Right, shoulder through. Crouch. Look at my eyes now. Bind. Set. I'm still looking forward. Now, out, right, don't move. Everyone break up. Everyone get up. Everyone get up. You stay down with me, hooker. I'm in that position there. Right, I'm just looking over my glasses. Show me. Square. Attack his heart there with your head. Jab that bind through. Put your inside foot back a bit more. Crouch. Bind. Sit. Drop your hips, drop your hips. Stay there, stay there, stay there, stay there. Hold, break. Okay. Don't move your feet.
Yep.
But from your torso upwards is pretty good. Show me one more. In fact, let's have another loose head in. Another one busting with enthusiasm. Get through, through. Get your shoulder through. Remember the table football game? Come through a bit more. No, I'm not going to smack you there, it's wrong. Crouch. Bind. Sit. Look over your glasses, look over your glasses. Break. Okay, there. As a loose head prop, your job is to keep hold of the tight head. Remember what I said about staying in lanes? You've got to keep that tight head off your hooker. You've got to engage him earlier to keep him off your hooker. Engage him square with your shoulder out. Crouch. You watch Joe Marler play. I think probably best technical scrummager in the Six Nations. Plays Harlequins. So, crouch. He'll start there. So he's ready for the bind. Again, no movement too late. He could start here. Okay, crouch. Have his arm up here. Bind, but he starts. Crouch. Bind. Check. He's in there. You've got to race the tight head in. You've got to make the tight head go. Ugh! And as a tight head, to the loose head, you've got to go 1 o'clock on him and make him put his chin on his chest. Now, as a loose head against me, you come here. If you're a tight head, sorry, against me. Yeah. If you don't engage me, if you don't make me put my chin on my chest, I'm going to attack you all day. Okay. Yeah? So you've got to go out on me and drop your shoulder. Right. With this shoulder here, you've got to keep that down and through to stop the hooker. Right? Yeah. I could be here all night talking technicalities. But if you're all square at the start, crouch, bind, set! Sorry, tight, 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 set! That makes sense, does it, as hookers? Throwing that little call as a hooker at the last moment. Any other questions? Should we go in and talk a bit for 10 minutes? Yeah, thanks lads, well done.